On September 14, 1988, the Philippines became a signatory to the Montreal Protocol. On March 21, 1991, the Philippine Senate officially ratified the country's commitment to the treaty. In 1992, the Philippine government, through the Department of Environment and Natural Resources Environmental Management Bureau, or DENR-EMB, established the Philippine Ozone Desk, which acts as the national coordinator for the implementation of the Montreal Protocol phase-out schedule.
The National CFC Phase-Out Plan, or the NCPP, is our commitment to the Montreal Protocol as a signatory to the Montreal Protocol that we will phase out ozone-depleting substances from usage in our country.
In September 2003, the Philippine Ozone Desk created the National CFC Phase-Out Plan, or NCPP, with a project management unit tasked to phase out the country's remaining CFC consumption in accordance with the Montreal Protocol. The NCPP, funded by the Multilateral Fund for the Implementation of the Montreal Protocol and administered by the World Bank and the Government of Sweden in a cooperative undertaking, is a comprehensive national phase-out strategy that employs a combination of policy and regulatory interventions, investment and non-investment activities, and technical assistance. Leading the implementation of the NCPP is the DENR-EMB, working with the EMB regional offices and concerned partner agencies such as the Department of Finance's Bureau of Customs, the Department of Labor and Employment's Technical Education and Skills Development Authority, or TESDA, the four bureaus of the Department of Trade and Industry, or DTI, namely Bureau of Trade, Regulation and Consumer Protection, Bureau of Product Standards, Bureau of Import Services, and Board of Investments, the Department of Transportation and Communications Land Transportation Office, or LTO, the Department of Health's Food and Drug Administration, or FDA, and the Land Bank of the Philippines as the co-implementing agency and financial intermediary.
The alarming rate of ozone depletion has led developed and developing countries to draw up an international agreement in 1987, which is the Montreal Protocol on substances that deplete the ozone layer. So this Montreal Protocol aims to reduce and eventually phase out the use of ozone depleting substances, particularly the CFCs and HCFCs that cause the ozone depletion in various applications. We need full support from various stakeholders, particularly those concerned government agencies and representatives from the industry sector to support the DENR, the Environmental Management Bureau of the DENR, in implementing major activities like this.
Under the NCPP, various programs and sub-projects of the government for the servicing sector were implemented. The DENR produced the Code of Practice for Refrigeration and Air Conditioning, or RAC, and Mobile Air Conditioning, or MAC. TESDA conducted training and certification of trainers and service technicians. The DENR launched the voucher system for RAC and MAC service shops. Under the voucher system of the NCPP, the DTI was in charge of the accreditation of service shops, and the LTO has conducted mandatory inspections of motor vehicles with MAC systems. The DENR also commissioned the Asian Institute of Journalism and Communication to conduct qualitative and quantitative research, including an awareness, knowledge, attitude, and practices survey, focus group discussions, in-depth interviews with different sectors and project stakeholders, and advocacy and communication skills enhancement trainings. The trainings equip the DENR and its partner agencies with capability-building skills to enable them to help in the implementation of the NCPP. for the collection, transport, and storage of refrigerants from refrigeration and air conditioning, and mobile air conditioning service shops, manufacturers, and chiller owners, the DENR contracted Delsa Chemicals and Multi Products Incorporated.
Focus of attack here is not the public, but the service centers. Nandiyan talaga yung refrigerants. Nandiyan nakatago lang sa equipments. And when they service their equipments, dapat talaga ma-recover yan. Kasi kung hindi ma-recover, kung basta-basta pasisingawin lang ng mga technicians yan, and which they are doing for now, hindi tayo makakakontribute sa kagandahan ng ating kalikasan.
The NCPP has provided technical and financial assistance to eligible small and medium-sized companies engaged in foam, tear gas, and refrigeration equipment manufacturing for the conversion of their production equipment to non-CFC-based technologies. A financial mechanism called the voucher system provided partial grant assistance to service shops to help them manage the use and handling of CFCs. North Star Refrigeration and Aircon Services is one of the service shop voucher grantees. 2,600 vouchers have been issued to eligible shops, enabling them to acquire tools and equipment for proper servicing, maintenance, and installation of refrigeration and air conditioning systems.
Bali, compose sa kanya na recovery machine, vacuum, and then yung thermometer, and then weighing scale, and yung gauge na ginagamit sa nitrogen. So kasama yon. At the same time, may kasama rin siyang gauges na ginagamit doon sa vacuum machine. Malaking tulong dahil nag-provide sila ng mga equipment.
Ako po si Romano Bondoc, isang certified technician ng TESDA. May natulong po kasi nasasabi ko sa mga customer na lalo na kung yung sasakyan po niya, yung CFC po, na nakakasira po ng ozone layer yon. Kasi ang kawawa po yung mga magiging susunod na henerasyon po natin.
Nakapagpa-retrofit na po ba kayo ng aircon nyo?
Oo, mula nung nalaman ko na ipagmawawala yung dati kong gamit ng pre-on, nakapag-retrofit na ako. May kamahalan nga lang, at saka wala naman akong naramdaman na magbabago sa lamig ng aircon. Pero at least, hindi na ako magproblema sa pag-register sa LTO next year.
According to the Philippine Ozone Desk, the importation of CFC into the Philippines continuously complied with the phase-out schedule set by the Montreal Protocol on substances that deplete the ozone layer. The complete ban on its importation was achieved in 2010.
Well, we have to continuously monitor the service shops and to make sure that these CFCs are no longer used by the public. The training that we started for the service shops, the technicians supervised by TESDA and accredited, the service shops are accredited by DTI, we have to continue to monitor these establishments.
Public awareness programs and information, education, and communication materials have also been launched. Civil Service Commission and the Commission on Higher Education granted the DENR's request to release memoranda suggesting activities for the International Day for the Preservation of the Ozone Layer on September 16. Specific ordinances pertaining to the complete elimination of CFCs in some city LGUs in the National Capital Region have also been drafted to support the advocacy. World Bank Senior Environmental Specialist Viraj Vithunchen lauded the DENR for the success of the CFC phase-out. He also cited the need for vigilance, however, as CFC-containing products may still enter the country illegally.
The project has been very successful because the Philippines already complete phase-out of CFC by the end of 2009, which is in line with what is required by the Montreal Protocol. We consider this as one of the more successful programs. Now we, for the CFC, we have to ensure that the achievement that we have thus far would be sustainable because there's still large quantity of virgin CFC in the international market. So we have to remain vigilant because there would be a flow of this CFC coming into Philippines illegally. And then the next step is how to deal with HCFC phase out, which is the next set of chemicals controlled by the Montreal Protocol.
To sustain the initiatives and efforts exerted in the implementation of the NCPP, private and public partnerships should work together towards making the Philippines a CFC-free country.